Positive psychology attempts to show another side of human nature to present a more balanced view of the world.
People like Socrates advocated self-knowledge, which is the sufficient condition to the good life. Plato's allegory of the cave influenced Western thinkers who believed that happiness is found by finding deeper meaning. Aristotle believed that happiness, or eudaimonia, is constituted by rational activity in accordance with virtue over a complete life. The Epicureans believed in reaching happiness through the enjoyment of simple pleasures. The Stoics believed that they could remain happy by being objective and reasonable. Even Thomas Jefferson and other proponents of democracy believed in life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness as basic rights. Abraham Maslow was one of the founders of humanistic psychology. Humanistic psychology looks at each individual's potential and stresses the importance of growth and self-actualization. The main belief of this psychology was that people are innately good. Carl Rogers was another psychologist who contributed to positive psychology. He emphasized person-centered theory, a concept of self-actualization. This concept implies that the individual's central motivation is to learn and to grow.
So what is positive psychology? According to Schultz and Schultz, authors of A History of Modern Psychology, positive psychology builds on the work of humanists and is the approach to psychology which asserts that we should be studying the best attributes of humans, not just the worst. Psychology should look at the positive in addition to studying the negative. According to Martin Seligman, one of the founders of the positive psychology movement, the main goal of positive psychology is to get psychologists to develop a more positive conception of human nature and human potential, and not just view psychology from a disease model, focusing on mental illness and the problems associated with human nature. Topics addressed in positive psychology are things such as subjective well-being, the science of happiness, love and life satisfaction, enhanced well-being, peak performance, positive affectivity, emotional creativity, optimism, hope, and goal setting. Martin Seligman is the man most often associated with the founding of the positive psychology movement. Before he founded positive psychology, he did work on learned helplessness. Since the founding of positive psychology, he has been the director of the Positive Psychology Center at the University of Pennsylvania. In 1998, he served as president of the American Psychological Association. He has written several books associated with positive psychology and lectures around the country. Within positive psychology, he has identified the goals for the movement: to be concerned with human strength as well as weakness, building strength as well as repairing damage, making lives of normal people fulfilling, and to nurture high talent. Seligman is noted for his work on happiness and the three paths of happiness that he has derived: the pleasant life, the life of engagement, or the meaningful life. Also associated with the founding of positive psychology, and cited by Martin Seligman as being the most influential person in the movement, is Hungarian-born Mihály Csikszentmihalyi. He is most noted for his influential work on creativity and his notion of the concept he calls flow. Previously, he served as head of the psychology department at the University of Chicago, and he is currently on staff at Claremont Graduate University. In this clip from an interview, he describes the concept of flow.
Flow is a state of mind or an experience, a state of experience that we feel when we are totally involved in what we are doing.
Positive psychology has affected almost every aspect of the social world, and applications of it are being used in military training, education at all levels of school, business organizations and administration, art, creativity, and the list goes on. Positive psychology has also been very popular in news stories, since most see it as a nice change of pace to hear uplifting stories in the news. Learning to be happier and increase productivity and creativity has a nearly universal appeal, and positive psychologists have released several top-selling self-help type books.
So, authentic happiness is a goal. In what ways is it not Pollyanna or just denial? Because critics might say, oh, this happiness, you know, the old guard might say this is a fight into health or a running away from suffering, you know, a disengagement from your pain, which is superficial.
Yeah, yeah.
You've heard that, I'm sure.
Not put as well, Rambo.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
You really did put it well and differently, and we will try to make this interview fun by having questions I haven't heard before. So my first reaction to that is I'm all for psychology as usual. I'm all for pain, undoing pain.
You have nothing against pain and suffering.
Nothing.
However, it may be argued, some people think that optimism and its various metaphorical offshoots, such as flow, intrinsic motivation, and the like, are all aspects of the same thing, and may derive naturally from contemporary definitions of reinforcement or reward that are rooted in our very biology. One expert states that positive psychology might not make space for people to feel bad. They believe that some people's lives are hard, and if they're having a hard time with something, it can make it harder for them to cope if they feel pressure to act okay when they're not. Others think we should be grooming our understanding of when it is best to use optimism and when it is best to use pessimism.